Good morning, High Tides. With April over, we're hoping that you may have a good month. But before we look forward, let's look at a great prom that us seniors ended April with.
Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide.
Prom was so much fun. Oh my god,
I almost died that night. It was crazy. It was so fun. I love prom. I love you. I love Beach High. Let's go, High. Woo! Okay, so prom was amazing. I love seeing everyone in their dresses. Everyone looked so beautiful. The food was so good. The pasta, amazing. The music, the DJ, the place was so beautiful. I had an amazing time.
Prom was amazing. It was one of the most spectacular experiences of my entire life.
Okay, I had a great time at prom. It was nice seeing all my friends in dress nice. And the food was amazing. The pasta was really good. I had a nice time.
Prom was surely a night to remember for the seniors, but prom isn't the only thing on the seniors' minds. There's been this disease that's been plaguing us for far too long.
High Tides, have you been feeling lazy, depressed, and unmotivated to do any work? Well, you may be suffering from a little thing called senioritis. Senioritis plagues many seniors and underclassmen around the U.S. The most common symptoms of this include procrastination, being lethargic, and missing school days. These symptoms usually show themselves to people during the second quarter of their last school year. As soon as the person gets senioritis, it's all downhill from there as they begin to care less and less about showing up to school and keeping up their grades. Senioritis shows itself when seniors realize that despite all their studying for useless skills, they are woefully unprepared to go into the real world, in which the subjects they had spent so much time studying end up useless. Let's see how many kids in Beach High have senioritis.
Yeah, I have senioritis. It's really bad. Like, I don't want to do anything anymore, so it's not that good.
Oh, yeah, senioritis definitely hit me hard, bro. I'm just ready to get out of here, bro. It was last quarter, last month, like.
I've had senioritis my entire life. Like, I've always been lazy.
High tides. Let's try not to get senioritis.
Try to stay motivated, High Tides. The year may be coming to a close, but every choice matters. If you decide to go the lazy route, try to steer away from relying on heavy junk foods. They're pretty detrimental to your health.
Have you ever been told to stay away from junk food? Probably. Sure, it tastes good, but it can cause serious problems to your health. Whether you eat junk food once in a while, couple of times a week, or almost every day, it is bad for you. 35% of adults and 41% of children's energy intake comes from junk food. This junk does not give your body the proteins and carbohydrates it needs. Eating it too much may make you feel fatigued, which can lower your energy levels. The high chance of teenagers to go through depression has increased by 58% due to not maintaining a healthy diet. Eating healthy meals is important for teens to maintain hormonal balance. Junk food replaces healthy fats in the brain and messes with its regular signaling mechanism. Junk food fats also slow down your ability to learn new things. Eating junk food can put you at risk of obesity and chronic diseases. These diseases could be cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, and some cancers. You are actually more at risk of having a heart attack by the more weight you gain. Fries and chips have a lot of processed salt, which makes you crave these salty foods. Blood pressure increases from high sodium you receive from salt, which can cause kidney disease. One of the most frightening risks from consuming junk food is that it puts you in danger of having dementia. Brown University performed a study that showed too much fattening food and sweets increases the insulin levels in your body. Insulin is what the brain produces to send signals between forming memories and nerve cells. The more you eat junk food, the more you crave it. Junk food has some serious and harmful consequences. Try to reduce or eliminate the amount you consume and fill your plate with greens and protein. Healthy foods also taste good.
If you need something to replace those Takis you're going to be throwing out, I might recommend a chimichanga or taco. I've been in the mood for Mexican food ever since May. You may know why.
Cinco de Mayo is the day we wear sombreros and eat Mexican food. But why? Originally, Cinco de Mayo was a day to commemorate a victory. On May 5, 1862, Mexico won against France in the Battle of Puebla.
Though this is a Mexican holiday, other countries use this day to celebrate and explore Mexican culture. During Cinco de Mayo, it's common to try Mexican delicacies, such as tamales or quesadillas and more. Some places throw a Mexican-themed parade with traditional dancing and mariachis performing. Miami is celebrating with a Cinco de Mayo Brico Fiesta. Happy Cinco de Mayo, High Tides!
As we move forward into this month, it's important that we commemorate an important figure that unfortunately is no longer with us. Though he may be departed from our month prior, he will remain in our thoughts.
A bond that me and him were quickly together was we were born on the same day. So something I will always remember on my birthday. So that's all.
I'm gonna say something, Coach.
All right.
Coach Garcia, girls tennis. I've only been at Beach High for 3 years.
Hi Tides, we hope you have a great May, and remember that no one is truly gone. The impacts they have on us cause not only their memory to live on, but their legacy to live on too. Have a great one, High Tides.